Welcome to Dell Technologies Recover Point for Virtual Machines, How-To Series. Recover Point for Virtual Machines, How to Update Certificates in RP4 VM 5.3 Environments. Reference Dell Knowledge Article Number 181907. This video was created to provide a clear procedure for certificates exchange or update in 5.3 releases between VRPA, vCenter Server, and Plugin Server. When to do this? If the vCenter Server or RP certificate has been changed to a self or CA signed ones rather than the default one. If the Plugin Server was unable to retrieve the default certificate automatically. When Plugin Server deployment is failing with certificate errors. Before you begin, make sure you have IP addresses and SSH access to VRPA's plugin and vCenter server. Root credentials for VRPA plugin and vCenter server. Credentials for the account used to register vCenter server to recover point. And WinSCP or other FTP client to move the files from or to the Linux host. Adding an RP certificate to the plugin server. Open a web browser and go to your vSphere HTML5 interface. When prompt login, enter your vCenter administrator account credentials. From menu tab, make sure to select Hosts and Clusters. Select the plugin server VM and open its web console. Log into the plugin server VM with root credentials and enter the command seen on the screen in CLI to enable SSH access on the plugin server. Now open SSH using root credentials to plugin server VM. Open SSH session to site control VRPA and log in as admin to enable root access on the system. Enter number 2 setup, 8 advanced options, 2 security options, then 3 enable root access. Create a duplicate session and log in as root. Enter the command displayed on the screen to copy RPA certificate into the plugin server VM. When prompt, enter the plugin server root password. Go to plugin server VM and run the command shown on the screen. Go back to vSphere client and power off the plugin server VM. Wait for 2 minutes and then power the VM back on. Adding vCenter certificate to plugin server. Open a web browser and go to the URL shown on the screen. Save the downloaded file on your local machine. Open WinSCP to use it in moving the certificate files from your local machine to the plugin server VM. When prompt to log in, enter the plugin server VM root credentials. Now go to the file you downloaded containing the vCenter certificate and extract it on your local machine. In WinSCP, go to the extracted folder in your local machine and move the certificate files present in certs lin folder to the plugin server VM anchors directory. Make sure to only copy files ending with .0 extension. Go to the plugin server VM SSH session and log in as root, then run the update certificate command shown on the screen. From vSphere web client, right-click on the plugin server VM to power it off. Wait for 2 minutes. Power the VM back on, adding vCenter certificate to recover point. Open a web browser and go to the URL shown on the screen to download vCenter server certificate. Save the downloaded file on your local machine. Open the file you downloaded and go to certs lin folder. Open the file ending with .0 extension in a notepad to copy vCenter certificate. Edit certificate format to match the format on the screen, including the hashtag at the end of the file. Open SSH session to site control IP address with admin account and add the certificate to the RPA. Select the options shown on the screen. Note that certificate alias can be any name of your choice. Paste the certificate and confirm it was added successfully. Go to the main menu, then a select System Management CLI. Run the command shown on the screen to update vCenter certificate. Enter the required information for vCenter server, then make sure update was successful. Note that reboot for site control RPA might be required. Reference the following for more information. KB181907. Thank you for watching.